నరసింహవామనాది మాధుసూదన రాజేంద్రనందన శ్యామ
Thank you. Thank you. The thin layer on the skin.
The thin layer on the skin.
Charma.
Charma.
Skin.
Skin.
Mamsa.
Mamsa.
Flesh.
Flesh.
Rudira.
Rudira.
Blood.
Blood.
Medha.
Medha.
Fat.
Fat.
Majja.
Majja.
Marrow.
Marrow.
Asti.
Asti.
Bone.
Bone.
Dhatava.
Dhatava.
Element.
Elements.
Bhumi.
Bhumi.
Earth.
Earth.
Ah.
Ah.
Water.
Water.
Teja.
Teja.
Fire.
Fire.
Maya.
Maya.
Predominating.
Predominating.
Sapta.
Sapta.
Seven.
Seven.
Prana.
Prana.
Breathing air.
Breathing air.
Yoma.
Yoma.
Sky.
Sky.
Ambu.
Ambu.
Water.
Water.
Vayubi.
Vayubi.
By the air.
By the air.
Translation. The seven elements of the body, namely the thin layer on the skin, the skin itself, the flesh, blood, fat, marrow, and bone are all made of earth, water, and fire. Whereas the life breath is produced by the sky, water, and air. Purport. By His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. The construction of the whole material world is prominently made by three elements, namely earth, water, and fire. But the living force is produced by sky, air, and water. So water is the common element in both the gross and subtle forms of all material creation. And it should be noted herewith that due to necessity, water being most prominent in the material world is the principal element of all the five. This material body is thus an embodiment of the five elements, and the gross manifestation is perceived because of three, namely earth, water, and fire. Sensations of touch are perceived due to the thin layer on the skin, and bone is as good as hard stone. The breathing air of life is produced of sky, air, and water. And therefore, open air the breathing air of life is produced of sky, air, and water, and therefore open air, regular bath, and ample space in which to live are favorable for healthy, vitality, fresh produce from the earth, like grains and vegetables, as well as fresh water and heat, is good for the upkeep of the gross body. Om Jnanati Mirandasya Jnanjana Shalakaya Chaksur Militamina Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Pancha Kaupata Rubyasya Kripa Sindhu Bhayevacha Padita Nam Pavanevyo Vaishnavevyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar, Shri Vasati Gaur Bhaktavinda, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama. So we've been hearing about the universal form and how the Lord produced the universal form. Now the topic seems to be changing a bit more. We're hearing about the construction of the material world. And we're told how the material body is made of earth, water, and fire. The material body. And then the life breath, which is the spiritual force within the body, that is produced by sky, water, and air. Actually, it's not exactly the spirit soul, but it's the breathing air of life. And here Srila Prabhupada gives us some comments about the importance of open air, regular bath, and ample space in which to live, how they are favorable for a healthy vitality. So we can see as Kali Yuga progresses that these things are becoming more and more rare. Open air in a city, very difficult. You will go to Kuala Lumpur today, you don't get much open air. And you don't get fresh air. It's whatever air is there is all polluted. Traffic. Regular bath is also mentioned. People in nowadays Kali Yuga very lazy. They don't like to bathe regularly. If they bathe once a week, they think that's good. If you live in countries where it's cold, of course, it's even more difficult. Like in Russia, it can be very cold in the winter time. And many people in Russia, they live in they don't live in the city, they live in the forest. Many people in Russia, the government, because it's a socialist country, so the government, they give land to people, they give pieces of land where they can go and live, but it's far. They live in the forest. So they live in the forest, there's no electricity there. There won't be much, or maybe some electricity. But anyway, they don't have hot water. And to bathe, they have to break the ice. You have to melt the ice. Everything is frozen because it's so cold. And temperatures are always zero or below. So everything is frozen. And so for people to bathe, very difficult.
Sure.
Huh?
Sure.
Yeah. to America, you know, he thought he was going to, when he went to America, he was thinking, you know, modern country must be luxurious living. But Prabhupada went, he was living in New York, and he found it difficult to get a bath, to be able to take bath. The people in America, even, they don't get to be regular. They don't have that habit. Especially living in big cities, and especially the lower income people, they don't have that facility to bathe regularly, to wash their clothes regularly. You know, we can wear the cloth and wash it every day, but in these countries, you know, they wear jeans and they wear these kind of clothes. They wash them very irregularly. And they wear things like jackets and, you know, they never wash them. They don't wash them. Maybe dry clean them. But that's expensive. Once in a blue moon, they dry clean. Yeah. So, clean clothes, fresh air, open air, bathing regularly. Very difficult. These are luxuries for most people. There was one place in China we went. The people there told us they take bath twice in a lifetime. They take bath when they're born, and they take bath the day they get married. Otherwise, no chance. I mean, it's so dry. It's just so dry there. There's no running water. They don't have running water. It's so dry in some parts of China. Desert, you know, dry, very dry. Not always desert, but still very dry. And they just don't have much water. And people who live in the countryside, they just can't do these things. So, it's not very good for healthy vitality to definitely your health is not going to be very good in such an environment. But the people are working in the fields every day. Actually, it's very healthy to go out and work with the earth. It's very good for health. People who are working in air-conditioned rooms, you work in a high-rise building, you know, like in America, they had those twin towers which got blown up. There were so many people working there in these twin towers. It's a very unhealthy life. No fresh air, no natural light. And working all day, looking at a computer screen or something, it's not a healthy lifestyle. And then their eating habits, of course, are also very poor. What do they eat? Very difficult for them to get fresh food. They eat the fast food. They go to the fast food. Kentucky Fried Chicken, McDonald's, and this kind of stuff. This is what people eat there every day. In Japan, people eat in the 7-Eleven every day. They go to 7-Eleven and buy something from there. You know? It's definitely not fresh. But Prabhupada said, fresh produce from the earth, like grains and vegetables, are the real food for people. So, try to influence people, try to get people to live a healthy lifestyle. It's very difficult for them. And this Prabhupada says that fresh water and heat is good for the upkeep of the gross body. Fresh water. You know, nowadays everybody drinks water, you get it from a bottle, mostly. You have to buy a bottle of water to drink some water. It's not fresh. It's been stored in some plastic bottle. So it's you know, plastic is very contaminating. They say it's fresh. Is it called a spring or something like that? But it's been in a plastic bottle. We don't know how long it's been stored in a plastic bottle. And the plastic bottles are often left outside in the sunlight, and so much the plastic melts, of course, in the sun, it goes in the water. This is the kind of water we drink. So to get fresh water is difficult. And heat is required. Of course, we get natural heat here in Malaysia. You have the sunlight, but often places, most of Europe, very cold in the winter time, it needs heating. You go to a country like Sweden, or Norway, or Finland, and Scandinavia, even England, very cold. More than half the year, be very cold. But people live in these conditions. You get heat. Where do you get the heat? They sit over a radiator, or they burn some kerosene to get some heat. Sometimes people in the past, they used to burn coal, have coal fires. In countries like China and Russia, people who live in the city, then the government are their sheep. The houses are heated in the winter time. They have a period when they supply heat. Like, it depends when the winter begins. You know, some places it will be November, and other places it will be October. And it will warm, be cold, the burning cold, generate heat the water. Water goes through the pipes and heats all the houses. So, a little bit warm, not very warm, a little bit. Just takes the chill off. So, the gross body is affected by these things. The gross body is affected by earth, water, and fire. And the subtle body, the life breath, is produced by sky, water, and air. So Prabhupada points out that water is a common element in both things. So water is a common element in both the gross and subtle forms of all material creation, and it should be noted herewith that due to necessity, water being most prominent in the material creation is the principal element of all the five. So water, of course, we're always being instructed not to waste water.
How to put subtle body? How to put subtle body? Gross body, subtle body.
How is it? How is
water.
Well, I don't know quite how it happens, but the combination of sky, Chapter is sky, water, and air can interact. With the water, you get moisture carried in the air. In the sky, water. Water evaporates. So water is the principal element. They're trying to always teach us not to waste water. And Prabhupada was also conscious of that. One time we were on a morning walk, and Prabhupada walked, we walked past this house, and there was water running. There was a tap outside the house. The water was running. Prabhupada said, "Don't turn on the tap." We didn't like to see anything wasted. It was very concerning about it. So water. Nowadays you go in the airport, they have these toilets now. They have this system, you know, they have automatic sensor water. They don't have the tap. It's automatic sensor. You put your hands there and the water will run.
Yeah, sensor.
Right? And they have a setup now that is 1, 2, 3. First you put your hands there and you get soap. A drop of soap will come. And you're supposed to run it. And then next is the water. And then next thing is the air. To dry you. It's all microchip technology. They have microchips everywhere. So even in the toilets, you know, they don't want, but people, they don't even know, they can't understand how to do it, you know. It's a whole new thing. And they're trying to save on water. Don't waste water. We're very expensive. When we pass stool and urine, these things are actually meant to go into fire. They're not meant to go into water. We put everything into the sea.
Water.
All the waste, all the stool and the urine and everything, the sewage, it all goes into the sea. Everything is put into the water. But actually, that's not proper in the living things. They burn everything. Put it into the fire.
Because they have open toilet.
Huh?
Because in India, only they have open toilet. Make them burn the sandal.
The sun?
Yeah, they have open toilet. Don't go out the land.
Pass in the fields. Pass in the field, everything goes back into the land.
Well, that is a proper way to do.
Well, they told me it's proper to do it in the fire. You have a fire.
It's put in the fire.
Yeah. Fire purifies everything. Not a good deal. Some people worship fire. They won't burn the body, like Parsi people, they don't burn the body because they worship fire.
Oh.
And what they do with the dead bodies, they feed them to the old church. You will see where Parsis are, they'll always be vultures. Because they know they'll get dead bodies. We burn the bodies and put them in the ground, bury them. Some places we put them in the sea. The water gets contaminated. Very contaminated, water, pure. You bathe in the sea, everybody's passing urine and spill, it's all going in the sea, all the sewage is in the sea. The water.
Yeah, all the rain water is the sea.
Huh?
All the rain water is the sea.
I think it's pure these days. predominant element in our material body is water. A little bit air and very less fire. Fire of digestion, right? You have to have some fire in the belly to eat. To have appetite, you need some fire. That's why people will do things like eat chili. You eat the chili, then put some fire in them, increase the digestion. Prabhupada used to eat some chili, you pick a chili, little chili.
Good fresh.
Yeah.
Increase the fire.
Increase the fire of digestion. But air, a little bit left in the body, most of it is water. Then we have to keep putting water in the body after drinking. Supposed to drink a couple of liters of water every day. That's healthy. You drink a couple of liters of water and because every day we need water to keep the body functioning, to keep the system running. If you don't drink enough water, you get problems. But the problem is to get fresh water. Just get some, find some bottle of water. We used to drink water when we were kids. We used to drink water from the tap.
My son also said.
Huh?
He also said, you know, to pick tap water.
Well, we had tap water. We can drink tap water.
But he had no sick, no anything.
Huh?
We have never feel sick anything.
No.
Directly.
But over the years, tap water, because it's not pure, it's all contaminated, but we can't drink it. They tell me that.
Yeah. Maybe for, they do the business for the mineral water,
yeah.
Stop us from drinking the tap water. What do you do?
Yeah, they want more business.
Yeah, I mean, everybody is now going to mineral water.
Yeah, you have to do this, you have to take that. The vaccination is also the same thing. Vaccination, it makes people more sick.
They want to hear.
You get more sick.
Then they can do a sell the business, all the medicine and insurance.
The little children and get more vaccinated, kids all grow up with these problems. Children diseases now. Why? Only because of the vaccines. The result.
You may say this is the mentality of the demoniac people who destroy. You say people of Kaliyuga, the god of the demon, come and destroy.
Yeah.
This is one of matter.
Yeah.
They're producing in the name of medicine, they kill everybody.
Yeah, Kali Yuga, so many people, so many corrupt people are...
It's all the engine of Kali.
Yeah. There's so many people just trying to just destroy everything for their own sense gratification, so they can exploit more, so they can take more the resources in the world for their own sense gratification. So countries, they fight over water. This is our water.
Yeah, India also same.
This water is ours.
They're fighting.
This
then
part
the flood,
of the ocean belongs to us.
But the flood, they already is.
The sea level the sea level is rising because the North Pole and the South Pole are melting. The North Pole, all the snow, the ice peaks, and they're all melting. There's a global warming. Global warming means the different big masses of ice on the North Pole and South Pole, they're melting. when they melt, then the sea level rises. And often they're trying to reclaim land. They're trying to take land from the sea, but at the same time the sea level is rising.
You also say you like a lot of life. Since then you're in the thing that make me like I actually all see the time. We are 20 years back to all see, he said. How do you be here?
Singapore, a lot of Singapore is being reclaimed. Reclaimed land.
That's a reclaim, a lot of
Hong Kong also reclaimed. Fill it up with stones and rocks. And then they build on it. So the water is tough. And the Sindhi people, they worship a deity, Julila. You know Julila? They say it's the god of the sea. I think it's Varuna, but they call it Julila. The Sindhi.
Oh, Sindhi. The Nora, yeah, Sindhi. Sindhi. Sindhi, Sindhi. Oh. That would be a Sindhi, the Nora.
In Sindhi. Hong Kong, I have a lot of Sindhi.
Yeah, he also have one or two.
The business people.
Ah, yeah, all business people. The mother did a little, your friend. The brother friend. The counter. Sindhi, Nora. She's coming to the class of water. So they worship the ocean, huh?
Yeah, they worship Julie Love.
Julie Love, isn't it?
This one deity. The deity is called Julie Love. They have a deity in the Hong Kong, the city of Hong Kong, Hindu temple in Hong Kong. He's got a mustache. And they say budget is that for Julie Long.
You wish it to wash it. Like a Varna. You call Varna. Varna.
The people who live on the sea by the coast, they're usually fishermen, people like that living on the coast. They will often worship the sea. Because every day they have to go out in the city, they have to risk all the big waves and the storms. So, there's in China, they have this, in Taiwan and China, where on the coast where they're fishing people, they worship this called Machu. Machu.
Water.
Okay, yeah, goddess of the sea.
Machu.
In the Pacific. They're risking the life of everything.
Yeah. Manju.
Anyway, water is a very important element in the creation. We have to make sure we get water, drink water.
Krishna was asked to offer the poem, water.
Huh?
Bhagavad Gita Krishna must offer the poem. Atram Krishna Parama Poem.
Yeah, water. Right. Krishna wants water. Just, he wants tulsi leaf. He wants not just any leaf, he wants tulsi. So when he wants water, probably he wants Ganga water. Ganga itself, that's water. When somebody dies, you're supposed to wash the mouth up with Ganga itself.
We still have culture, custom, when Indians, they are dying, they bring water, like how they bring from the sea, you know, to be far and carry the water and take the body, body part from the body, then custom.
Bring from the sea?
No, bring from the sea, but a little bit far and carry the water like how they carry, how they bring from the sea. Carry the water. Basically, the children or the son, the students, the things they do. affected by the water and the beautiful wet back shed, then it do the ceremony for the dead body, the father or parents.
Well, they bathe the dead body, right?
Before that, they must bathe the person.
Before what?
Before that, do the ceremony for the baby ceremony. The person, the parent, children must also take bath. Must carry the water. But now we really use the little take the water.
Take water from the pipe?
Pipe and you.
Huh?
Because you don't keep the ginga water. You don't get the ginga water. Take the pipe water.
You can call the Holy River by mantra.
Ah, yeah. Normal also, normal Indian also follow this. Purify the dead body by holy water. Change how he use?
Who is?
The church in Christianity.
Christian? And on the Catholic Church now, Catholic, they have the wine and they have the biscuit or some kind of thing. They do have a baptism. Mm-hmm. Baptism, when you become a member of the church, at that time they do have a baptism. And like a child, we baptize, we put some water on them, holy water.
Ceremony for the Ram temple, there were different countries send the water, a pot of water for the opening ceremony for the Ram.
Well, when we had, what was it, Prabhupada's 50th, they brought water from?
Yeah, 1,000, huh?
Yeah. They went, one of our devotees, he went and collected water, Lokanath Swami, and engaged them, he sent them all the different places, collecting water. Only water from all the different places, from all the different temples.
It's very important. for them to break the ice and make the water.
Yeah.
So when the Panikra, all the Russians take bath very early. They like to take bath.
Yeah.
Like in cold water, take bath.
Oh, that's a few Russians. I think all the Russians are like that. Those are a few Russians. They're fortunate ones who come there to Mayapur.
Yeah.
But in Russia, it's a whole different thing. It's very different.
So great these people come in Krishna Kansasa. Totally a different culture.
You live in Russia, you know, it's not easy, it's very cold. China also very cold, even Europe, very cold.
That's why these people all come holy down here, stay there.
Yeah.
Why?
They're so happy, they like to stay here, but it's not easy. Government don't give you enough. I need money, you can't get money. But certainly they enjoy, they appreciate. You know, you live in a cold country, you have to have winter clothes, you know.
Yeah.
You have to have big shoes, heavy shoes to go through the snow.
Yeah.
You have to have all kinds of things to keep warm.
Very challenge for them to practice Krishna consciousness in bath, early morning, early time.
Yeah, in early morning, the coldest time of the day, you know, very cold. I wake up early in the morning, very cold. Take a bath, how to take it. If you don't want water, it's very cold. Sometimes we would be traveling. We jump out, we're staying in the van. We jump out the van and kick snow, just kick back in the snow.
What is that?
Drop the body with snow. That was our bath. Kick back in the snow. And Prabhu Vishnu, Prabhu, he wrote to Prabhupada about that. And he's telling Prabhupada how they were staying in the van and taking a bath in the snow. And Prabhupada wrote back to him and he said, I can tell this is all just like fun for you. This is just play. This is just like play, just like children play. You're not considering it very good. Prabhupada is very nice. He said, this is very nice that you live like that. You practice that kind of, do that kind of austere living. It's very purifying.
Because the endeavor is there. Enthusiasm and endeavor is there.
Nowhere to stay. One time, I was in America, we were traveling, and we got in a snowstorm. It was a snowstorm. We couldn't move, and all the roads were blocked and jammed. We couldn't go in. And so they arranged that many cars were all stuck, that we were put into a church. And it was this big church, and we were all staying in the church. But we wanted, you know, we wanted to do our sadhana, so how to take bath, you know? So we went outside in the snow, we took bath in the snow and came back inside the tent. That was our morning bath. You can do these things sometimes, but you can't do it forever.
Yeah, they did all the
especially like these places, the water is so, even if they have water from the tap, it's so cold. Even in the summertime, the water from the tap is so cold. When it comes out from that very deep below the ground. So even in the summertime, the water comes out. So that's why Chinese people usually don't have hot water. They have to have hot water because the water is so cold. I was staying in China. The hot water is only certain times when you can get hot water. So if I wanted to do some washing vegetables, I have to wash the vegetables in cold water. Because the water is so cold.